The concepts underlying tidy data have been around for decades and may seem familiar if you've ever worked with relational databases. In 2014, Hadley Wickham wrote a paper in the Journal of Statistical Software called Tidy Data, which summarizes these concepts in a clear and concise way. In this chapter, we'll introduce these concepts and review some simple and practical methods of implementing them in R. Here's an example of tidy data. For each of four people, we have a name, age, eye color, and height in feet and inches. Looking across the first row, we see that Jake is 34 years old, has hazel eyes, and is 6 feet 1 inch tall. This row is called an observation. Looking down the second column, we see the distribution of ages among our four subjects. This column is called a variable or attribute, and each individual age is considered a value of the age variable. If we were to give this table a name, we might call it something like people, since each observation describes characteristics of a single person, also known as an observational unit. If some rows, instead of describing individual people, described characteristics of their pets or perhaps their favorite movies, then the table would be said to contain more than one type of observational unit. This is always true of tidy data. Observations are represented as rows, variables are represented as columns, and there is exactly one type of observational unit per table. Said differently, a data set is a collection of values. Each value belongs to both a variable and an observation. A variable contains all values that measure the same attribute across units, and an observation contains all values measured on the same unit across attributes. Now that we've seen the principles of tidy data, let's look at a simple example of messy data and try to figure out what's wrong with it. Observations are still in rows, and we only have one type of observational unit, people, in this table. It even appears that each column is a variable. Notice, however, that the columns brown, blue, and other are actually values of what was previously the eye color variable. This is a common symptom of messy data. Column headers are values, not variable names. When talking about data sets, it's often convenient to refer to them as either wide or long. Although these definitions are somewhat imprecise, they generally refer to situations when you have more columns than rows or more rows than columns, respectively. However, a less strict interpretation is simply that a wide data set tends to represent key attributes of the data horizontally in a table instead of vertically, similar to the example from the last example that you saw. The opposite is true for long data sets. Now, let's test your understanding of tidy data.